Welcome to my CBSE English teacher. Today let's learn the lesson The Ghat of the Only World by Amitabh Ghosh from class 11 English. If you're watching my video for the first time, consider subscribing. You can listen to the explanations of lessons from classes 10, 11 and 12 English. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. Let's move on to the video now. About the author. Amitabh Ghosh was born in Calcutta and grew up in India, Bangladesh and Sri Lanka. He studied in Delhi, Oxford and Alexandria and is the author of The Circle of Reason, The Shadow Lines, In an Antique Land, Dancing in Cambodia, The Calcutta Chromosome, The Glass Palace, The Hungry Tide and The Ibis Trilogy, consisting of Sea of Poppies, River of Smoke and Flood of Fire. Amitabh Ghosh holds 2 Lifetime Achievement Awards and 4 Honorary Doctorates. Introduction. This is a glowing tribute to his Kashmiri friend Shahid, who died of cancer in America. Shahid was a poet. He also taught at various colleges and universities in the US. His brother and 2 sisters were also settled there. He was adored by his students, loved and admired by his friend. He himself had a broad and secular outlook. He condemned fanaticism and violence in Kashmir. Here is a summary. Agha Shahid Ali was a Kashmiri settled in the US. He was a cancer patient. He had been under treatment for 14 months, but he was still on his feet and cheerful. Only sometimes he became unconscious, lost his memory and his eyesight for a short while. On 25th April 2001, he spoke to the writer about his approaching death. The writer tried to console him, but he was cut short. Shahid, however, made a request. He wanted the writer to write something about him after his death. Shahid and the author had studied together at Delhi University, but they had never met. In 1998 and 1999, they had several conversations on the phone and also met a couple of times. But the acquaintance could not grow until both moved to Brooklyn, US. They were in the same neighborhood. Shahid lived in a building some 8 blocks away. He had a sudden blackout in February 2000. He had a malignant brain tumor. So from Manhattan, he moved to Brooklyn where his younger sister Samita lived. When Shahid spoke about his approaching death, he laughed, but he was dead serious. He entrusted a great responsibility to the author. "You must write about me," he said, and the author promised to grant his wish. Since that day, he started noting down all his conversations with Shahid, and that record helped him keep his word. Shahid was a poet who wrote in English. The author had read his 1997 collection, The Country with a Post Office. He was greatly impressed also. Once they became neighbors at Brooklyn, they began to meet very often for meals. Shahid's condition was serious, but that illness did not depress him. The author and Shahid had many common friends. They also shared a love of Rogan Josh and liking for Kishore Kumar's song. Both disliked cricket and loved old Mumbai films. They began to meet regularly. One day, the author went along with Shahid's brother and sister, Iqbal and Hina, to fetch him home from the hospital. It was on May 21st. Shahid had already been through several operations that failed. A hospital staff arrived with a wheelchair, but Shahid sent him back. He thought that he was strong enough to walk out of the hospital on his own, but his knees buckled only after a few steps. The hospital staff was summoned again with the wheelchair. Shahid loved company, partying and shared meals. He didn't have much time to be depressed. His apartment was on the 7th floor, but it was worth going all the way up. There was the fragrance of Rogan Josh and songs to welcome the visitor. Shahid would open the door and clap his hands joyously. There were poets, students, writers, and relatives in the house. Even though his health was failing, he loved to talk, laugh, eat, and of course enjoy poetry. His deep interest in kitchen matched with his skill as a poet. James Merrill had a great influence on his poetry. He dreamt that he was at the Ghat of the only world. Shahid was not a fanatic. He regretted that Pandits had left Kashmir, and he expressed that feeling in his poetry. He loved Bengali food too. He loved the poetry of Begum Akhtar. His repartees were equally sharp. Once at the Barcelona airport, the security guard, a woman, asked him what he did. His answer was that he was a poet and his vocation was to write poetry. Finally, that woman asked if he was carrying anything that could be dangerous to the other passengers. Shahid cried out, "Only my heart." He was very popular as a teacher. He taught at several colleges and universities. He was appointed a professor in 1999 and he had his first blackout in February 2000. After 1975, Shahid lived mainly in America, where he joined his brother and two sisters. His parents continued to live in Srinagar. The political violence in Kashmir had a great effect on him, but he was not a political poet. He was true to his art form of language. His vision was all-embracing. He had a secular outlook. In his childhood, he once created a small Hindu temple in his room in Srinagar. His parents never stood in his way. On 4th May, he had gone to the hospital for a test to discover whether the course of chemotherapy had the desired effect or not. The next day, he told the author that the doctors were going to stop all his medicines and there was not much hope. He wanted to go back to Kashmir to die, to be with his father. But for certain reasons, he had changed his mind. He died in the US and he was laid to rest in Northampton. He died peacefully in his sleep at 2 p.m. on 8 December 2001. Shahid loved Kashmir and wrote passionately about the issues related to Kashmir. He was content to be called a national poet, but not an extreme nationalist. He had his own moderate views, which were not extreme at all. He believed in inclusion and pluralism. He liked and respected other cultures and religions. Questions and answers. Question number 1. What information do you gather about Shahid from this lesson? Answer. Shahid was a Kashmiri by birth. He had migrated to the US. He was a man of letters, a poet and professor. But he contracted cancer from there. He was under treatment for 14 months. He was operated upon thrice for a brain tumor. But no treatment could save him from his untimely death. Question number 2. How did the author come to know of Shahid's approaching death? Answer. Once while scanning and thumbing through his engagement book, Shahid spoke that he could not see a thing. He added that he hoped that he did not mean that he was dying. This telephonic talk between Shahid and the author gave the author a feeling of Shahid's approaching death. Question number 3. When and where did Amitav and Shahid become friends? How did their friendship grow? Answer. Shahid and Amitav became friends in Brooklyn, US. They lived a few blocks apart, but they began to meet for occasional meals. By that time, Shahid's condition was already serious, but that did not stand in the progress of their friendship. I hope you liked today's video. For more interesting videos, do subscribe to my CBSE English teacher. Like, share and give your valuable comments below. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching.